They're so small, they have such tiny, tiny brains, but yet they're amazingly flexible and robust at doing what they're doing, which is biting us. So my name is Jeff Riffell. I am a mosquito researcher here at the University of Washington. Mosquitoes are remarkably good at trying to locate a person to drink their blood. They are vampires, and they're very good at what they're doing. Their eyes, their vision, their nose, everything about them is geared towards finding us and biting us. These are the mosquitoes. We keep them here. They put their eggs in water or near water, and then they will hatch out as what are called larvae, and they swim around. And then they will, what's called pupate, they will hatch out as adults. And these are both kind of males and females kind of flying around here. These are the ones that we'll be testing in behavior experiments that we try to understand what they do. If you think you are a mosquito magnet, it's probably the case. Some individuals are bitten way more than others. The smell of our skin, the sweat, the breath, our carbon dioxide that we're emitting is actually a really strong cue for the mosquitoes. And of course, the clothes that we're wearing. They dislike white and they dislike green, but red, especially black, they love those two colors and they'll go to you. Unfortunately, they can learn. If you are very attractive and they bite you and drink your blood, they will then go back to you because they learned this kind of positive association. The good news is that they can learn to avoid you. So if you're trying to swat them, they'll learn that and they'll avoid you a little bit. The females are the only ones that are biting and sucking our blood. The males, by contrast, and the females go to flowers and other plants to get nectar, to get sugar.
Mosquitoes can detect three different types of sugar sources, so one of them being fruits. And so we're basically trying to create the perfume that mosquitoes are naturally inclined towards. If we attract them, then what we can do is we can lace it with toxin, and then it kills them, basically.
Mosquitoes, unfortunately, kill up to 1 million people per year. So the information that we're kind of developing and finding in the laboratory has real world implications and can really help, I think, many people in many different parts of the world.